repeat after me. Putter the butter.
I gotta putter that butter.
Woo! All right. Drizzle it right on there.
Okay.
Perfect. That's first. That's step one. All right. And then.
Okay.
Okay. Now we're gonna splatter some batter.
So we're gonna splatter that batter
on the middle of the griddle. So we're gonna put one ladle here, there.
All right.
Man, that is perfect.
Don't get anything on your suit, Ruben.
You are making a perfect pancake.
This is
here.
Like $1,000 suit. So for real, if I get anything on this suit, everybody's gonna pay.
You know, the good thing is it's a work expense, so it's tax deductible. All right, that looks perfect, Ruben.
Is that good?
Yep.
Three of them bad boys?
All right, so we're gonna switch right over. I'm gonna have you just go ahead and pour out.
I'm just gonna pour it?
Yep, just like a little pour right here. That's perfect. That is gonna make one tasty cheesecake pancake.
You notice how many times he said perfect during this little thing? That's when you know you're on top of your game.
Okay, now we're gonna wait, and we're gonna see the little bubbles form, This is the gas releasing. Steam comes up, cooks a pancake. You wanna see how if they're still shiny on top here?
Yeah.
They haven't popped yet.
Okay.
When they start popping and those little bubbles stay, that's when you know it's gonna be ready to flip. Okay.
When it's on and popping is when it's time to flip.
It's on and popping.
As you would say. Okay.
And then it's gonna be a quick flip.
A quick flip.
So not quite yet. We gotta wait.
You puttered the butter.
Then you splattered the batter.
Yeah, splattered the batter.
Yep.
Somebody give me a beat. Man, you got a beat for me?
And then we got the beatbox over here.
Wait till the bubbles are popping. Because the bubbles are popping.
Those look fine. It looks like whatever, you know, precipitation. That's a technical word I stole from Joe.
Woo!
That's fallen may have cleared up by now.
Feel like a scientist this morning?
My brain just got bigger.
The biggest word I've ever heard you use.
Precipitation.
Precipitation. Go right there.
A little fancy this morning.
I'm fancy, Joe. I drink my tea with my pinky up. I don't know if you know that. I'm fancy.
All right, we do have one more story to share with you before we get to your final forecast. The former home. This is a 6-foot teddy bear. And it's $89. You can buy it at Walmart. Yeah, I think if I came home and saw this, I might be a little startled, to each
that's
their
huge.
Own. Yeah.
It's huge. Yeah. Let's lift it all the way up. Lift it all the way. This thing is legit 6 foot tall.
Yeah. So there's that. Another popular gift idea, instead of flowers, you might want to go the candy route. So these are candy bouquets. They're the new roses is what people at Walmart are telling us. And there are tons of these to choose from. You can buy them for $19, perfect for anyone with a sweet tooth. And we also have these, stop it, these beauty boxes. We have a time limit on this thing, so I'm trying to get through this right now. This one is called the main.
All right, let's take a look at the latest COVID-19 numbers over the last 24 hours. Kind of show you the trend and how things are going. We did add 266 new cases to the overall case count. We've passed the 516,000 mark at this point in time. Active cases, the number we've continued to watch, continuing their decline. They dropped by 52, so we have 4,580 people total battling the virus right now in the state. Unfortunately, we did add 14 more COVID-19 related deaths. You see there on the board there, we're getting closer to 8,500 fatalities since the pandemic began. Hospitalizations continuing their roller coaster, their up and down movement, right down several days last week, up by 10 in the last 24 hours. We have 290 people currently in the hospital. Of those 290, 73 people are currently using ventilators.
On to something now a little less appetizing. Doorbell cameras allow you to see your visitors more clearly.
Yeah, this is a really weird one. But as one California family found out, there are some things you just can't unsee. Check it out. This man in California was caught on camera licking a family's doorbell. What are you doing, bro? Milling around the yard for like 3 hours. Cameras also reportedly caught the man relieving himself. That doesn't surprise me at all in the front yard before he moved on to someone else's house.
All right, although very shocking and disturbing.
What are you doing right now?
The homeowners say at the end of the day, no real harm was done. The footage did help authorities, though, identify the suspect. They say he could be facing a number of charges. The family says they've since cleaned their doorbell.
I would imagine so. What do you do when that dude shows up with his tongue hanging? What do you do?
He sat there and licked on that door for a long time.
Yeah, not that a short time is okay, but...
Yeah, no amount of time. You're right. No amount of time is appropriate, but a long time is just...
He was really licking that thing. He was really... I just don't understand what his mindset was
It was
at all.
Altered.
I think it was. I think he thought it tasted like apricot.
Apricots. Turning now to the tragedy at Astroworld in Houston, as 8 people died in some sort of crowd surge there.
Yeah, you may have seen some of this video. Take a look at this video. This is all from people who were actually at the event. You've probably seen some of that circulating on social media already. This morning, we're actually hearing from a father and a son from Fort Smith who were actually there, Laura.
5 News reporter Micah Wilson spoke with them about their terrifying experience.
All right, so we've talked a lot now, Laura, about the school districts and everybody changing their mask mandate. Let's show people kind of why that is as we take a look at the ACHI map here on the screen.
Yeah, when the school year first started, I mean, this whole map was pretty much red, but now you can see that there are barely any districts in Northwest Arkansas and the River Valley with red. So there's just 2. This one is Scranton right here, yeah. And this one is Waldron. So those are the only parts of our part of the state that are in the red.
Yeah, so if you continue to look at the map, though, you can see way up here. Here, this is Rogers and Bentonville. They're both in the yellow. That means they have 20 or less of those active cases. And then you've got Lincoln, Greenland, and West Fork all over here in the green. So what you're starting to see is that trend. As you see, we're way different than the other side of the state, where it's still very, very red. That why, as a parent, you're probably wondering, why are these changes happening? That's why.
Yeah, and to put this in perspective, red basically means that there are 50 or more positive cases in that part of the state per 10,000 people. So that's to put those numbers in perspective.
Important to note, there are no purple counties, school districts anywhere on the map. Purple is the highest level of infections.
Yeah, I think 100 or more.
Yeah, that you can reach. So everybody trending in the right direction right now. Now, each year, drinking strengthens coworkers' relationships. A quarter of the people also say it has led to better job opportunities. Researchers say raising a glass with your boss can be beneficial because it allows you to establish a less formal relationship. However, don't hit the drinks too hard. People in the survey also say they tend to limit happy hour drinks with coworkers to 2 and tend to order beer and wine over hard liquor. Mm. So don't get too excited, Joe.
Yeah, it's one of those things that's kind of like, I tend to shy away from stuff like that.
Yeah. Basically, what that study says is for me to like you 2, we got to get drunk.
It's saying 1 or 2 drinks.
It's saying we got to take shots so I can get along with y'all in the mornings, is what it's basically telling me.
It's a little early for shots.
I'm just going by the study. Don't judge me. I didn't come up with the study.
I think you just pick and choose which studies you like to.
Say to take shots with your coworkers at 5 in the morning.
I have selective hearing.
Some people need to drink to deal with coworkers, right?
You got something to say?
No. Just making an observation.
A throwback to his sports days with the Supra. Some nice cars, Joe.
Yeah, that big Lord, Ram. I saw the big Ram a second ago. That thing is huge.
I'm thinking about getting a new car anyway, and so I might just have to go over there and see if they'll let me test drive a couple.
Yeah.
And you do get to test drive those indoors. I went to the Chicago Auto Show 1 year, and they had a whole little test track you could actually drive a pickup truck on.
So they didn't check your driving record before they let you test drive?
I have a perfect driving record.
Your car says otherwise.
People have hit me.
The bandages on your car says other than perfect.
People have hit me. Not my fault.
That's what I always say, too. It's not my fault. I felt like it was only appropriate before you watch this guy. I think it's only appropriate you know who. It's kind of like a candidate for political office, right? You want to know about him. But I think it's time that you know a little bit more about Matt Sanders. Okay. He eats dry ramen noodles. That's weird. He eats dry frosted flakes. Shredded bean and wheat. That's weird. He brings whole loaves of old bread to work and eats it without any butter, jelly, or anything. That's weird. But this might be from communist Russia or something. I don't even know where this is from. Matt, will you tell the people how I like applesauce? You like applesauce, Matt?
I
like applesauce. Hey, Kevin, you like applesauce?
It's always good.
Oh, man, applesauce, that's an American treat. Everybody loves that. John, you like a little applesauce?
For sure.
Oh, for sure. Laura Simon even likes applesauce. Don't you lie, Laura? Like a little applesauce?
Sure.
But we all like applesauce in a bowl with a spoon. Matt, how do you like your applesauce?
I like it straight.
Straight? Like it's liquor? Are you taking it straight to the head?
It's like this.
Show them how you eat applesauce.
I got this full jar, full 48 ounces.
48 ounces. Drinks it straight. Look at the rest of the people's reaction. No, look at John's face. John's face is literally a meme. Do that again. Show the people again. Like, that's weird, bro.
That's weird.
I don't have a spoon. I don't have a bowl.
Dirty up a spoon.
Okay, dirty.
I take dishes.
There we go.
Thank you.
That is not a viable excuse for eating it like a weirdo.
But let me make this clear. We had this question earlier. I hate when people drink out of the carton for milk or orange juice or things like that, but or pop or anything like that. But when it comes to applesauce, straight from the bottle is okay.
First of all, it's not liquor. Stop talking about it like it's whiskey. Okay? That's first of all.
This is like my morning
First of all, that's not whiskey. Chill out. Second of all, that's weird, Matt.
I think even
Laura Simon would agree that that's weird.
I might even get a straw next time.
Laura, would you agree that drinking applesauce straight out of the container is weird?
It's a little weird.
That's even Laura, and Laura co-signs for Matt on everything.
Laura's got a pretty level head.
If Laura says it's weird, Matt.
But I do think that they, you know how they have
go-gurts
and the tube? Yep. They need to make that with applesauce.
They have that for
sense.
Little kids.
But that would make sense.
Yeah, but that's not a tube.
But no, for grown-ups,
they have a tube. Yeah. Exactly. It's the grown-up version.
This is not a tube.
It's the family version.
What about sticking a straw in there? Would you do that?
I would do a straw. The thing is, I used to
buy a straw with applesauce?
I've done that, and I got it on my lapel before.
How fast will you go through a jar?
Well, I started yesterday.
Yes, he had a full jar yesterday.
All right, let's talk servings here.
Oh, yeah, please break down his servings.
There are 11 servings in this jar of applesauce. So 11 times 90, that's how many calories are in here.
How do you feel about that? Who cares? That's what I said yesterday.
19 grams of sugar, so times that by 90.
Yeah, Matt, are you shamed yet?
I'm sorry, times 19 by 11 for the servings. That's how many servings.
That's how you get hair like that.
The ingredients in this are apples, sugar, water.
Sugar, Matt. You hear that?
Ascorbic acid to maintain color. I don't recommend drinking applesauce.
So she just said you're drinking acid. That's what she just told you.
One serving of this is okay, but to have a whole jar in two days, not so much.
Matt, it doesn't matter how much it costs you. The point of it is you are sticking your mouth on the lid there and just eating it raw, just no spoon, no nothing.
Mm-hmm. I'm almost done with that. I'm going to have to get another.
Did you have a rough childhood? Did you guys not have spoons as children? Is that where this comes from?
I had the responsibility.
You good?
Yeah, I got one in my dish right now.
My responsibility was dishwashing every single night. So I was mowing and I was dishwashing.
So basically, you're traumatized.
Because my brother was also, I have a twin brother. He was also supposed to do dishwashing, but
he never did.
Well, he would do it, but he would do it badly. And so mom would come over and be like, "These dishes are awful," over and over again, to the point where, "Brett, you're not allowed to do dishes," which is really smart. So I had to do dishes the rest of my life.
Okay.
So now I try to save dishes.
I just stole this from her.
Yeah, this is not as fun though.
I almost won't put it all the way in the jar.
I know.
You're so deep in the jar at this point, Matt.
Why don't you pour it in a bowl?
I have a bowl.
Oh my god.
You're married in a bowl.
Mm-hmm. It doesn't taste the same.
Matt, I don't hate you. I don't hate you. But I'm this close to punching you in the throat. I mean, you're one more weird thing away from getting kicked off the island.
Have you had enough?
You're almost kicked off the island.
Me and Alfonso are going to drink.
Alfonso.
You remember that?
He still doesn't know the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. You're quit. Find a new job. You're fired. I don't care what we have to do. You're out of here.